Today I'm making a dessert type dish. It is what I'll call peanut butter chocolate chip fluff. Now I was going for ice cream because, well, it's summertime and who doesn't love a nice dish of ice cream, but it didn't turn out as good as I wanted. So I decided to not freeze it and make it like a pudding fluff. And it is delicious. It's creamy. It's got the mouth feel. We've got some whipping cream in this to get that. We're using honey to sweeten it up. And you can always adjust that. If you want it a little sweeter, you can add a little more. If you want it less, you can cut back a little bit. But all in all, it's a great summer treat, and I think you're gonna love it. I'm Rockin' Robin, and I'm gonna show you how to make it right after my chef joke. What do you call pudding that's starting to go bad? Off-putting. I'm big on ingredients, so today I'm using Clover Organic Heavy Whipping Cream, and you check out these ingredients. I love the fact that there's just cream in it. We'll start with the heavy cream in a large bowl because we're gonna mix that first. We're gonna add some real vanilla extract, and we're gonna blend it up. Mix this until you get some soft peaks. We don't wanna make it really stiff, we just wanna bring it to some nice soft peaks where it's almost done. Something like this. I like to add protein to my desserts, so today I'm using Icelandic yogurt here. Icelandic and Greek yogurts tend to have more protein per serving and less sugar. I'm adding 2 cups here to the whipping cream, and don't forget you can get the written recipe below the video in the description area. I'm also adding some Laura Scudder's smooth peanut butter. I like this brand because, of course, there's just peanuts and salt, and it comes in a glass jar. To sweeten this up, we're going in with some raw honey. Normally when I'm measuring out honey, I like to put a little oil in my measuring cup so that the honey flows out real easy and leaves no residue in the bottom of the container. Well, I can't do that with this recipe, so we just have to take our time and scoop it out. Now we'll take our blender and really mix this up. You want this to be well incorporated. Take your spatula and scrape down the sides of the bowl just to make sure everything is mixed. I recommend taking a little taste just to see if it's sweet enough for you. So if not, go ahead and add a little more like I did here and mix away again. All right, it's time for chef joke number 2. What is the motto of an ice cream shop in paradise? Have a nice day. Felt like I needed some chocolate in this, so I went with my favorite Guittard milk chocolate chips. Got my scale here, so we're going to measure out, I say, between 2 and 3 ounces. I say go more with 3 because it's so much better. And because these chips happen to be on the larger side, I'm going to slide them off and place them on my cutting board and chop them up. I really like this combination where you end up with some shaved chocolate along with a few chunks, so it's really nice. I'll just sprinkle that in and take a spatula and then fold it in. This will keep in the refrigerator for 4, maybe 5 days. You will notice this next day that it might get a little watery on the bottom, and that's not a problem. All you do is take a spoon and stir it up really well, and it just kind of refluffs it up. Place this in containers with a tight-fitting lid and place it right in the fridge. You can eat it now, too, though. It's nice and fluffy. And I also find that it seems to be even thicker the next day. So for the video, I went and put this in the freezer for about 15 minutes, and you can see it really did get a little firm. But believe me, I think it's much better as a fluff than trying to make ice cream out of it. This has a creamy, peanut buttery flavor that has the chocolate chips. You're going to love this. Let me know in the comments if you're going to try this, and if you do try it, let me know what you think of it. And if you're really into chocolate and peanut butter, you're going to want to try my chocolate pie with peanut butter graham cracker crust. It's delicious. Click the link on the screen. It'll take you right to the recipe. Did you enjoy today's video? If you did, let me know by smashing the old like button and leave me a comment. All right, we'll see you back here next week for another delicious and healthy recipe.